Welcome back for the series of lectures of engineering mechanics. So we are discussing about the last part of unit 2, that is equilibrium of rigid bodies, that is finding the support reactions of the beams for various loadings or under various load conditions. So we'll start now for the next example, which was asked in university examination, and they have mentioned that find the support reactions for the beam which is loaded and supported as shown in this figure. So A and B are the two ends of the beam, where A is a hinged and B is a supported by a roller. Couple moments are acting on this beam. One of them is a 50 Newton meter, which is in a clockwise direction. And they have shown here that it is acting at a distance of 2 meters from end A. Whereas the another couple moment of a magnitude 10 newtons meter is acting at a distance of 2 meters from the end B. And it is asked to find out the magnitudes of support reactions those are getting generated at point A and at point B. So firstly, what we will do, we'll go for the FBD of the same. But before proceeding to the FBD, we'll mark the reactions and their directions at the respective supports. So regarding a support A, that is a hinge one, how many reactions will be there at hinge?
Two
reactions will be there. Out of that, one will be along the plane of a contact, that is along the x-axis we can say, and another one will be perpendicular to the plane of the contact, that will be along the y-axis. So I would like to generate the dotted x and y-axis firstly, so that we will get an exact idea that where actually that reactions are acting. Okay, so now here at this point, the reaction will be along the y-axis. Now tell me the direction of the RAY. We have to assume it, and it's totally up to us. That is assuming in upward or a downward direction. So what do you want to say? Upward or downward? Bula. Kasha assume karachi? Upward assume karachi ki downward assume karachi?
Downward.
Downward. Okay, so we'll assume that downward. Let it be. Aapla answer wrong yenar nahi hai. Only there will be the change in the direction. That is, the answer will be the negative and nothing else than that. So we are assuming that RAY is downward, whereas RAX, it will be towards the right hand side and left hand side. RAX, right hand side or left hand side? Are you kudasli banana? So we'll assume that towards the right hand side, force is not acting along the x-axis, means Rx will be practically zero, but we are assuming that it is towards the right hand side. Now come at the roller, that is at a point B. Firstly, I would like to once again generate the dotted x-axis, dotted y-axis through the point B. Okay, now tell me how many reactions that a roller used to offer.
One.
That is always perpendicular to the plane of a contact or a plane over which it is to roll. So, konta surface hai? Ha surface hai. Ya surface to roll hoto hai. Manje surface x-axis la hai, horizontal hai. Manje reaction barobar ya surface la perpendicular asnar. Single reaction hai. Mi directly dila R B asul hito. Now tell me the direction. Assume the direction. Apnala assume karaycha hai. Upward gaycha ki downward gaycha? Chuklo tari chalel. Don't worry.
Upward.
Upward give it. Okay, chalo. So we are assuming that the reaction RB is a vertically upward at a point B. Okay. Now, can we go for a FBD or we will move only along with the same? FBD separate kaaduyat ki ahe so pude jaya.
Asus pude jaya.
Okay, chalo ha. Now, it is asked to find out the magnitudes of the reactions at the support. That is, RAY is asked, RAX is asked to calculate, and RB is asked to calculate. Under which condition? Under this loading condition. It means that we have to find out the magnitudes of the reactions those are getting developed at the supports when this beam is in equilibrium under the application of two couples. Don couple yachyavarti act hota hai. Kya veles tya reaction chi magnitude kay asel te apnala kadaycha hai. So write down applying conditions of equilibrium. Applying conditions of equilibrium. Which type of force system is this?
Non-coplanar concurrent.
Non-coplanar concurrent या coplanar concurrent? Which type of force system is this?
Coplanar non-concurrent.
Non-concurrent.
Coplanar non-concurrent. It is non-coplanar concurrent.
Coplanar non-concurrent.
It is a coplanar because all are lying in a single plane. It is non-concurrent because all are not passing through the single plane. It means that we will be able to apply the conditions of equilibrium. That is a summation moment is equals to zero. Then summation of forces along the y-axis is equals to zero, and a summation of forces along the x-axis is equals to zero. Now tell me, which condition we have to prepare firstly?
Summation moment is equal to zero.
At which point we have to take the summation moment?
A point.
A point.
At point A. So go for taking moment at A. Taking moment at point A, we get. So summation moment at point A is equals to zero. Now tell me, which moments will become zero here?
Rax
and Ray. Rax and Ray या दोघांचं moment काय होणार? Zero होणार. Clear? कारण दोघांचं line of action हे point A मधून pass झालं. Now tell me, what is remained and how they will act?
RB.
RB. RB rotating clockwise and anticlockwise to the point A. RB हा या beam ला वरती ढकलतोय. मग जर का आपण A च्या ठिकाणी beam पकडला तर तो कसा फिरेल रे? Clockwise की anticlockwise?
Anticlockwise.
So it will be minus reaction RB into its distance from point of application to the moment center. किती आहे ते?
6.
6 meters. So minus RB into 6. That is over. Now next. Which one you want to go for? 50 Newton meter or 100 Newton meter?
50.
Tell me now. It's a moment.
Positive 50.
Positive.
Plus 50. Yala apan distance ne multiply karnar nahi hai because already it is a moment. As it is clockwise, so we'll consider it as a positive. Now what is remain?
Minus 100
is equals to zero. So put up the values. Minus RB into 6. 50 minus, sorry, plus 50 minus 100. That is a?
Minus 50
is equals to zero. That is a RB into 6. That is minus RB into 6 is equals to plus 50. Na?
Yes, sir.
Minus RB into 6 is equals to 50. That is? RB is equals to 50 upon 6. That is a minus. So what is the magnitude for RB?
8.33.
Plus or minus?
Minus.
50 by 6, that is a 8.334 unit will be? Unit. Unit will be a Newton. But answer is a negative. What does it mean about?
Direction.
Direction is wrong. So write down below that. Negative sign indicates that. Negative sign indicates that. Negative sign indicates that. Assumed direction is wrong. Assumed direction is wrong. So next line. Therefore.
Sir, घेतानाच कळते ना की direction चुकली आहे म्हणून.
Simple example आहे म्हणून लक्षात येतंय ते. जर का examples difficult असतील, combination forces ची जास्त असतील, तर त्या केस मध्ये आपल्या लक्षात येत नाही की कोणती direction आपली बरोबर असेल. Okay, so let it be. चुकू दे, काय प्रॉब्लेम येत नाहीये. चुकते म्हणजे काय होतंय? Only direction is becoming wrong. Magnitude is the same. 8.33 न्यूटन. तर आरबी आपण अपवर्ड घेतलाय, बरोबर आहे का? अपवर्ड असताना तो चुकीचा होता, म्हणजे करेक्ट कसा असणार आहे?
डाऊनवर्ड.
सो इन ब्रॅकेट वी हॅव टू शो इट्स अ करेक्ट डिरेक्शन डाऊनवर्ड. okay? And at the same time, by using the pen, we have to make the correct arrow for the reaction RB, larger dimension. We have to mark the tick like this. It indicates this direction is a correct for RB. थोड़ा सा मोठी डायरेक्शन दाखवायचा, मोठा एरो काढायचा, व्हिच इंडिकेट्स द करेक्ट डायरेक्शन ऑफ अ रिएक्शन आर बी. आले सर्वांचं आंसर आर बी च?
यस सर.
यस सर.
नाउ व्हाट इज नेक्स्ट?
समेशन एफ वाय इज इक्वल टू
0. राइट डाउन देन, कंसीडर समेशन एफ वाय इज इक्वल्स टू 0. दैट इज इक्वल्स टू, टेल मी इक्वेशन नाउ. Who will be there in this?
R A Y
plus minus.
Minus.
Minus R A Y. हा next R B. आता R B घेताना जी direction correct आली होती ती घ्यायची. तर डाउनवर्ड येते, बरोबर आहे का?
म्हणजे म्हणजे
प्लस की मायनस होता?
मायनस.
मायनस.
मायनस R B Y.
R B R B ना R B Y नाहीये, फक्त R B आहे तो, बरोबर आहे का? Is equals to 0, that is minus R A Y minus 8.334 is equals to 0, that is R A Y, sorry, minus R A Y is equals to plus 8.334, that is R A Y is equals to minus 8.334. So here RAY is equals to minus 8.334 newtons. Right on, below that, the negative sign indicates that. Kya indicate karte negative sign?
Direction wrong.
Assumed direction is wrong. Indicates assumed direction. Assumed direction of RAY is wrong. Now correct it. म्हणजे काय चेंज होईल आता? आर ए वाय इन्स्टेड ऑफ कमिंग डाउनवर्ड इट विल बी गोइंग अपवर्ड. सो मेक द लार्जर एरो हियर फॉर आर ए वाय, इट इज गोइंग अपवर्ड. ओके, सो दॅट इज रिएक्शन आर ए, सॉरी ए हॅज टू बी सफिक्स. रिएक्शन आर ए वाय इज इक्वल्स टू प्लस 8.334 न्यूटन एंड करेक्ट डायरेक्शन इज अ वर्टिकली अपवर्ड. ओके, सो वी गॉट नाउ आर ए वाय, वी गॉट आर बी. नाउ व्हाट एल्स रिमेन?
आर एक्स.
आर एक्स. सो रिएक्शन इज अलोंग द एक्स एक्सिस, मीन्स वी विल बी गो, विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू गो फॉर समेशन एफ एक्स. सो कंसिडर दॅट, सो समेशन एफ एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू 0, इट यील्ड्स द व्हॅल्यू फॉर आर एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू 0. Now take the resultant reaction at A. So resultant reaction at A will be RA, it will be equals to root of RA x square plus RA y square. कारण तो दोन रिएक्शन आहेत, आर एक्स आणि आर ए वाय, त्या दोघांची रिझल्टंट रिएक्शन. परंतु आर एक्स किती आपला 0 आहे, म्हणजे काय येईल? रूट मध्ये आर ए वाय चा स्क्वेअर. जर का रूट घेतलं तर काय येणार आहे? तसं आर ए वाय च येणार. So that is RA is equals to 8.334 newton. मग त्या अँगल काय असेल रे आर ए वाय चा, सॉरी आर ए चा अँगल काय असेल? रिझल्टंट अँगल. रिझल्टंटचा अँगल कसा करतो आपण? अल्फा इज इक्वल्स टू टॅन इनवर्स ऑफ समेशन एफ वाय, म्हणजे काय? आर ए वाय डिवाइडेड बाय समेशन एफ एक्स, म्हणजेच आर ए एक्स. तर आर एक्स 0 आहे, बरोबर आहे का? आर एक्स 0 मीन्स समथिंग बाय 0 इज 0 and tan inverse 0 is always 90 degree, barobar hai ka?
Yes sir.
So alpha is a 90 degree, it means that ra is nothing but the ray, resultant reaction hi ray chi ani rax chi ra ch asnar, ti vertically upward asnar. Consider now the next example, that is a 5.2.31. it was also asked in a university examination. They are asked to find out the magnitudes of the support reactions at the ends A and B for the loading condition which is given to us. The loads are as like this: 10 kN, a point load acting at a distance of 2 meters from the point A, that is exactly at the point C. Then at the point F, that is 2 meters from the end B, it's a 15 kilonewton, and between D to E, that is over the span of 2 meters, the load of 5 kilonewton per meter is acting, and that is nothing but the uniformly
distributed
load. So this is a UDL of a 5 kilonewton per meter acting over the span DE, that is 2 meters, and at the end B, they had given us the support as a roller, which is rolling over an inclined plane of 45 degrees. It means that we have to find out the reactions for this particular loading condition, and for that we'll be required to convert this 5 kilonewton per meter to the point load firstly. So before proceeding to that, firstly we'll mark the number of reactions. Those are getting generated at the supports and their arbitrary directions, or we are going to assume their reactions rather, we can say. Okay, so firstly I would like to go for a point A, where the support is a hinged one. This is a hinge support. So firstly, what we have to do, we have to generate the dotted x-axis and dotted y-axis. Why we have to do this like this? Because whenever we are generating dotted x and y-axis at a particular points of our joints or the supports, we can say, we used to get an idea that how the reactions are, in which quadrant those reactions or the forces are acting. So I did the same. So now regarding the joint A or support A, at support A, the type of support is a hinged. It means that it is going to offer the two reactions. One will be perpendicular to the contacting surface. Contacting surface is a horizontal. This is a contacting surface. It is a horizontal. It means the one of the reaction will be along this plane, means along the x-axis, we can say, that will be here only. That's a transmission of the load yuthe yenar ahe, parantu starting the forces mule load yuthe yenar, yuthe the dhakkal yenar either towards the right or towards the left, and ultimately balanced kuthe honar, so balanced rate barobar base la honar. But we are going to show that reaction exactly at this point, x value. Now, the another one will be perpendicular to this contacting surface. So surface is horizontal, so reaction will be vertical, that is along this y-axis, which we have shown over here. So my question is that firstly, we have to assume the direction of a reaction, that is which we have considered along the y-axis. So this will be R-A-Y. Now tell me the reaction. We have to assume direction, we have to assume the direction of a reaction, R-A-Y, upward or downward?
Upward.
Okay. So we will assume that it is upward. We don't know exactly. आपल्याला एक्झॅक्टली माहित नाही की रिएक्शन खाली येणार आहे की वर जाणार आहे, परंतु आपण अज्युम केलं की अपवर्ड आहे. जर का आपली डिरेक्शन चुकली तर काय होणार आहे? देअर विल बी द ओनली निगेटिव्ह साइन फॉर द आन्सर अँड नथिंग इज दॅन दॅट. सो नाव नेक्स्ट वन इज द रिएक्शन अलॉंग द एक्स एक्सिस ऑर अ हॉरिझॉन्टल वी कॅन से दॅट विल बी आर ए एक्स. सो माय क्वेश्चन इज दॅट फॉर दिस पर्टिक्युलर कंडिशन इज आर ए एक्स इज गोइंग टू एक्झिस्ट ऑर नॉट. X direction la displacement hoil ki nahi hoil a cha thikani loading tumcha samor ahe, supporting system tumcha samor ahe, hou shakel kare? Hou shakel ka gove? Is it possible to have a displacement at a point A? Yes or no? Let it be answer correct or wrong, it doesn't matter.
Yes sir,
displacement hoo shakel. Okay, so probable kuthe hoo shakel re displacement, towards the right or towards the left?
Towards the left.
Towards the left means reaction will be towards the
right.
Right, so we'll assume that RAX is towards the right hand side. So this is the assumed direction for RAX. So now the regarding support A, the things we have done. Now regarding at a B, that is a support at a B, this is the contacting surface over which the roller is a sliding, rolling, we can say. Rolling will be the appropriate word. So the reaction will be perpendicular to this plane because roller offers only one reaction. So here I would like to go for a perpendicular line to this contacting surface. This will be our reaction RB. Now regarding the direction of RB, firstly upward or downward direction? we will assume that reaction RB is upward, which is perpendicular to this plane. Dotted x axis, dotted y axis at the B also, so that we will get an idea now how the RB is getting inclined to the horizontal. This will be the angle of RB with respect to horizontal. To get that angle, we have to close this lower triangle, which is formed by the support and the reaction. So this is a 90, this is a 45. So this line will be x axis once again, and its inclination will be 45 degrees. Is that angle made by the reaction RB with respect to horizontal will be 45 degree, and that will be the a single reaction RB. Is it clear now up to this point? इथपर्यंत सर्वांना समजले काय काय केलं आपण ते.
Yes sir.
Okay. Now the next phase is that we have to convert this given uniformly distributed load to the point load. So UDL to the point load, I would like to write here UDL, that is conversion of UDL to the point load. मला सांगा आता हा दिलेला युनिफॉर्मली डिस्ट्रीब्युटेड लोड आहे त्याचा पॉइंट लोड कसा काढायचा रे
इंटेन्सिटी
इंटू स्पॅन लेंथ इज गिव्हन टू अस लेंथ इज नथिंग बट द स्पॅन हाईट इज गिव्हन टू अस दॅट इज नथिंग बट द इंटेन्सिटी सो एरिया वी हॅव टू गो फॉर नथिंग एल्स देन दॅट दॅट इज इक्वल्स टू इंटेन्सिटी इंटू स्पॅन गो फॉर साइड बाय साइड इंटेन्सिटी इंटू द स्पॅन दॅट इज इक्वल्स टू इंटेन्सिटी किती आहे फाईव्ह आहे की टू आहे
फाईव्ह
इंटू स्पॅन इज अ So that is equals to 5 into 2, 20 ki 40?
10.
10. 5 into 2 as a 10, unit will be Newton, ya kilonewton, ya kilonewton meter.
Kilonewton.
It will be kilonewton.
Kilonewton.
How is it so? Because 5 is having unit as a kilonewton per meter, 2 is having unit as a meter. So meter gets cancelled, so we'll have the unit as a kilonewton. Now what is the next point?
Point of application.
Great. So go for it. Point of application. कुठं असतं रे बाबा UDL च
सेंटरला
बरोबर सेंटरला म्हणजे कुठं असणार हाफ ऑफ द स्पॅन सो स्पॅन अपॉन टू स्पॅन कोण आहे DEA बरोबर आहे का स्पॅन इज DE अपॉन टू सो DE किती आहे हा स्पॅन इथपर्यंत ऍक्ट होत आहे तो 2 मीटर आहे सो 2 अपॉन 2 इज इट 1 मीटर फ्रॉम विच एंड
डी अँड ई
डी ऑर ई
डी ऑर ई आयदर डी ऑर ई क्लियर नाव The next, go for the FBD because here a number of forces, reactions and all those things are much more. So we'll go for the FBD firstly. Okay, so go for the free body diagram of it. So I'd like to go for the beam. Firstly, the beam as it is. This is the beam AB. Okay, then it's reactions. Or firstly go for a dotted x-axis and y-axis at both the ends, that is at end A and end B. This is end B. And here, this is the end A. Left hand side A and right hand side B is there. Okay. Now, At A, we have assumed the RAY vertically upward. So show as it is here. RAY. RAX, we have assumed towards the right hand side. So show its a direction. Then at the B, reaction RB is there. And where it is going?
Inclined.
Inclined upward. Okay, so this is a reaction RB. And its angle to the horizontal is 45 degrees.
45.
Okay. Then, mark the spans. 2 meter span, 1 meter span, then 2 meter span, 1 meter, and lastly 2 meters. Or mark the points as a C, then this one as a D, E and F. Now the various forces those are acting over there. At point C, there is a point load of 10 kilonewton acting vertically downward. Then at F, there is a point load acting vertically downward, whose magnitude is 15 kilonewtons. Then what else remain? What is remain?
Uniformly distributed
point load.
Point load.
Yes, point load of this UDL, which is acting at a distance of 1 meter from D and E. Its magnitude is 10 kilonewtons. So that is exactly at the center of a DE. You have to consider acting vertically downward, and its magnitude as 10 kilonewton. So the span we have calculated as 1 meter. So this is 1 meter, and for right hand side also 1 meters. Now the given spans we have to show on the lower side or the below side of the beam. That is 2 meters. Then this one as 1 meters. Then D to E, 2 meter. E to F, 1 meter. And F to B, once again 2 meters. Is it correct up to this?
Yes, sir.
Have you understood up to this step? Just I had drawn the FBD and nothing is in that. This is the free body diagram, we can say. Now, we have to find out the reaction Rx, Ray, and the reaction Rb. So what to do? What to do now?
Condition of equilibrium.
Applying conditions of equilibrium. So write down below that. Applying conditions of equilibrium, we get applying conditions of equilibrium, we get. So that is pahila equilibrium cha conditions lihto mi to summation moment is equals to zero. And next kudli hai
summation f y is equal to
zero and summation fx is equals to zero. तर पहिला कंडिशन कोणती वापरायची?
मोमेंट.
मोमेंट कुठं घ्यायचं?
एला
घेऊयात. सो सडन बिलो टेकिंग मोमेंट ऍट पॉइंट ए. टेकिंग मोमेंट ऍट पॉइंट ए वी गेट. सो समेशन ऑफ अ मोमेंट ऑफ अ फोर्सेस ऍट ए इज इक्वल्स टू झिरो. नाउ टेल मी हु विल बिकम झिरो अँड हु विल बी देअर फॉर द रोटेशनल इफेक्ट.
Ray
and Rx, zero. Zero. Right.
RB.
RB. Huh? How come RB? RB is inclined now, isn't it? So what will be required to do? Will be required to resolve that RB. So extend its line of action. So this is its line of action. So vertically upward, it's a y component. Kunacha
RB-cha.
RBY and X component could say right like left la.
Left la.
So left hand side
la
X asnar. Hey, roller chi ekas reaction hoti RBOD. Parantu apan kai kele tila resolve kele X component la ni Y component la. Kabra karan apnala itho moment gates hai ani incline asla mule tesa direct distance apnala mirat nahi hai. So that we have resolve it. आता मला सांगा आरबी एक्स चं मोमेंट एच ए ह्या पॉइंटला किती असेल रे?
झिरो.
झिरो
बिकॉज द लाईन ऑफ ऍक्शन ऑफ द आरबी एक्स इज अ पासिंग थ्रू द पॉइंट ए. इजंट इट? सो व्हाट एल्स रिमेन नाऊ?
आरबी वाय.
बी वाय.
रोटेशन क्लॉकवाइज अँटी क्लॉकवाइज.
क्लॉकवाइज.
क्लॉकवाइज चाललंय इथं. बरोबर इथं अपवर्ड जाते म्हणजे बीमला वरती ढकलतंय. जर का ए ला आपण असं फिट
पकडलं
अँटी क्लॉकवाइज. सो मायनस आर बी वाय इन टू डिस्टन्स. आता हा व्हर्टिकली अपवर्ड आहे, उभा आहे, डिस्टन्स आडवं पाहिजे. किती येईल?
8 मीटर.
8 मीटर
मीन्स दिस 2 + 1 + 2 + 5 + 1 + 6 + 2 = 8. म्हणजे ए ते बी डिस्टन्स असेल. मी पहिला ए बी सी डीच्या भाषेमध्ये लिहितो. डिस्टन्स विल बी ए टू द बी. हे आर बी वाय झालं. नेक्स्ट सांगा बोला, पुढचं कोण असेल?
10 kilonewton.
Okay, chalo. We'll start with this 10 kilonewton. Rotation of a 10 kilonewton to the point A, clockwise or anticlockwise?
Clockwise.
It will be plus 10 into distance. C to D, ki D to E.
AC.
Distance AC. Is AC. Exactly. Distance is a AC. Point of application is a C and moment center is a A. So moment arm is a AC. Now next is a this 10 kilonewton I would have to go for. Rotation clockwise or anticlockwise?
Clockwise.
Clockwise.
So it will be once again plus 10 into distance E to D.
AE.
रोटेशन क्लॉकवाइज या एंटी क्लॉकवाइज
clockwise.
So once again clockwise a 15 into distance E up to B.
A up
ki up B.
A up.
A to the F asnar na karan A ha moment center hai and F ha point of application hai. So distance is A up is equals to 0. Now put up the values. That is a minus RBY into AB kiti apla 8 meters na? 8 meters plus 10 into A to C, that is a
2 meters
plus
10
into A to the G,
four meters
that is a 4 meters plus next wala kon hai tha
15
15 into A to the F.
6 meters
is equals to 0. That is minus RBY into 8 plus current multiplication summation 10 into 2, 20 plus 40, 60. 60 plus 90. Is it 150?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So 150 is equals to 0. That is minus RBY into 8 is equals to minus 150. Okay, so now both the sides are having minus sign, so minus minus will become
plus.
So that is RBY equals to
150 upon 8,
that is 18.75.
सर आरबीवाय घेताना त्याला साइन 45 ने मल्टिप्लाय नाही का करायचे?
नाही, काय गरज नाहीये. आपण आरबी ला रिझॉल्व केलं ना, आरबी म्हणजे आरबी सॉरी आरबीचा आपण वाय कंपाऊंड घेतलेला आहे. आरबीवाय हा आरबीवाय म्हणजे काय असणार आहे? आरबी साइन. ते आपण पुढे करणार ना, त्याला पुढे जाऊन आपण करणार आहे. सध्याला आपल्याला कोण मिळाला?
आपण मुवमेंट काढताना करत होतो ना साइन मल्टिप्लाय.
कुठल्या साइनला? काय गरज नाही ना, आपण घेताना कंपाऊंड काय घेतला? आरबीचा आरबी हा वरती चालत आपला इकडे, बरोबर आहे का? असं हा. सो व्हाट वी डीड, वी हॅव रिझॉल्व्ह इट अलॉंग द एक्स अँड वाय एक्सिस. मग मी काय केलं, त्याला याला आरबी वाय नाव दिलं, याला आरबी एक्स दिलं. आता आरबी वाय म्हणजेच आरबी साइन करा. तर नेक्स्ट स्टेपला काय करा, आरबी वाय म्हणजेच कोण असणार? आरबी साइन. दॅट इज, सो गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट लाईन. दॅट इज आरबी साइन ऑफ 45 ना?
Yes, sir.
Is equals to 18.75. That is RB is equals to. Now calculate the magnitude for RB. काय दे? 18.75 upon sine 45. Upon sine 45. Is it 26 point?
Yes, sir. 26.516.
516,
sir.
517 na?
6, yeah.
Ha, 517. 517. Now we got RB. आपण काय मिळालं? रिएक्शन आर बी मिळाली. आता आपल्याला काय पाहिजे आहे, आर ए वाय पाहिजे आहे आणि आर ए एक्स पाहिजे आहे. सो फर्स्टली वी विल गो फॉर आर ए वाय. तर आर ए वाय जर का आपल्याला कॅल्क्युलेट करायचं असेल तर आपल्याला कोणती कंडिशन ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम घ्यावं लागेल रे?
समेशन ऑफ वाय इज इक्वल टू,
गो फॉर दॅट. सो कन्सिडर अ समेशन ऑफ अ फोर्सेस अलॉंग द वाय एक्सिस इज इक्वल टू झिरो. नाव टेल मी वन बाय वन. हा
प्लस आर ए वाय.
आर ए वाय आणि इथं आपला आर बी च आन्सर प्लस आलतं म्हणजे डायरेक्शन बरोबर आहे. ओके सो आर ए वाय प्लस. हा पुढे बोला. हा
मायनस टेन.
स्केच आय वुड लाइक टू गो फॉर द स्केच ऑल्सो साइड बाय साइड. मायनस टेन, मायनस मायनस फिफ्टीन,
मायनस फिफ्टीन
प्लस आर बी वाय बरोबर आहे का?
Yes,
sir. Is equals to zero. So put out the known values. R A Y minus 10, 10, 15. Is it 35?
Yes, sir.
Minus
35.
Okay. So minus 35. Huh? Combination ke, let it be. Huh? Plus R B Y is known to us. R B Y ची value किती आहे? आपल्याकडे आहे R B Y already काढलेलं आपण. किती होता? 18.75. So, 18.75 is equals to 0. That is RAY minus
16.25.
Calculation was to karabar ka? 18.75. Is it 16.25?
Yes, sir.
Minus or plus?
Minus.
So RAY is equals to plus 16.25 kilonewtons. This is the magnitude for RAY. Once again, answer is positive. Means assume the direction for RAY is a
correct.
Now what else remain?
RAX.
RAX. Go for that RAX. काय करावं लागेल आपल्याला RAX साठी रे? ओके ग्रेट. कन्सिडर अ समेशन ऑफ अ फोर्सेस अलॉंग द एक्स एक्सिस इज इक्वल टू झिरो. नाउ टेल मी हू विल बी देअर इन अ समेशन ऑफ एक्स?
आर ए एक्स
प्लस या मायनस?
प्लस.
आर ए एक्स प्लस. हा देन
मायनस
आर बी एक्स इज इक्वल टू झिरो. दॅट इज RAX is equals to RBX. RB आपल्याला माहिती आहे. सो RAX is equals to RBX म्हणजे काय रे?
RB sin theta.
RB cos theta.
RB sin theta.
Cos theta.
Cos 45.
RB cos 45. That is RB. How much RB was there?
5175 cos 45 18.75 yes sir 18.75 kilonewtons yes sir answer is positive means what direction is correct assume the direction is correct for RAX.
आता इथे आपल्याला आर एक्स मिळालंय, आर ए वाय मिळालंय. आपल्याला ह्या दोघांचं काय करावं लागेल? वी गॉट आर ए एक्स, वी गॉट आर ए वाय. व्हाट विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू डू नाउ? रिझल्टंट रिएक्शन काढावं लागेल ह्या दोघांचं. सो गो फॉर द रिझल्टंट रिएक्शन ऍट पॉइंट ए. दॅट इज आर ए. वी कॅन से कशी काढणार आता रिझल्टंट रिएक्शन?
root r a x square plus r equal to root r a
exactly square. Go for that r a x it's a square plus r a y it's a square. Now put up the values and tell me directly the magnitude for a reaction r a. Do the calculations neatly. 18.75 square plus dusra kon hai r a y. तो किती आहे? 16.25. इट्स अ स्क्वेअर. हे 615 पॉइंट समथिंग येतो. रूट ऑफ दॅट Is it 24.81 kilo newton. This is the reaction Ra. Okay. तर याचा क्वाड्रंट आपल्याला माहिती आहे कोणता क्वाड्रंट असेल रिएक्शन आर ए चा बिकॉज बोथ आर एक्स अँड आर ए वाय आर
पॉझिटिव्ह
सो वी विल अज्यूम दॅट द रिएक्शन आर ए इज अ समथिंग एल्स हियर गोइंग अपवर्ड नाव वील बी रिक्वायर्ड टू फाइंड आउट इट्स अँगल अल्फा सो अल्फा इज इक्वल्स टू मी डिरेक्टली लिहितो tan inverse of ha bula tan inverse kona kona dasel
16.21
ra y upon ra x now tell me directly directly magnitude for alpha magnitude for alpha
sir 40 sir 40.80
40 examination for 10 marks and also for the 3 marks 10 7 and 3 marks likewise combinedly they have asked for different examinations what they asked find out the support reactions for the beam which is loaded and supported as shown below so this is the beam AB which type of the beam is this AB ha beam kontya type cha re
UVD
overhanging hai exactly single overhanging hai ki double overhanging hai re
डबल ओवर हैंगिंग है सर
इज इट अ सिंगल ओवर हैंगिंग या डबल ओवर हैंगिंग
सिंगल है
इट इज अ सिंगल ओवर हैंगिंग बिकॉज़ इट्स अ पोर्शन इज एक्सटेंडिंग ओनली बियॉन्ड ए एंड नॉट बियॉन्ड द बी ओके सो दिस इज अ सिंगल ओवर हैंगिंग बीम एंड इट इज आस्क्ड टू फाइंड आउट द सपोर्ट रिएक्शंस सो हियर द व्हाटएवर द लोड्स दोस आर गिवन अस दोस लोड्स आर नॉट अ पॉइंट लोड्स बट दे आर द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ यूडीएल एंड द यूवीएल नाउ particularly we will consider this portion I would like to go for the nomenclature of the same suppose that this corner as a C and here as a D end so this has a C end this has a D end and this is A so for this particular case if you look into the loading here so we are finding that there is a triangle from this point I would like to consider this point as a E apex point for this triangle as a E so there is a ACE one type of a triangular that is a uniformly varying load and another one is EAD EAD is another uniformly varying load so intensity for both of them is a 10 kN per meter that is maximum intensity zero intensity at the point C and at the point D is there for those triangular load that is a uniformly varying load we can say which type of the load is this I would like to go for the names E there so F and here as a G so dfgb which type of load is this kunta type cha load hai re ha fgbd kunta type cha load hai which type of the load is this
varying load
yeah is it a combination
combination
It is a combination. You can look into the sketch neatly. You will find that this load DFGB is a combination of a UDL and UVL. It is a combination of uniformly distributed load and uniformly varying load. Now tell me which is the UDL and which one portion is the UVL. याच्यापैकी कोणता portion हा UDL साठी असेल आणि कोणता portion हा UVL साठी असेल रे?
सर त्याला त्यासाठी लाइन ड्रॉ करावं लागेल ना
अगदी बरोबर आहे अगदी बरोबर आहे पण कुठून लाईन ड्रॉ करावी लागेल पॅरलल कोणाला पॅरलल
बीडी
डी बीला ओके सो आय लाईक टू गो फॉर अ पॅरलल लाईन टू द डीबी फ्रॉम द पॉइंट एफ मी लाइन ड्रॉ के लिए पैरेलल आता मला सांगा व्हिच इज यूडीएल एंड व्हिच इज यूव्हीएल
एफडी
खालचा पोर्शन यूडीएल आहे
खालचा पोर्शन हा यूडीएल आणि वरचा पोर्शन हा यूव्हीएल आहे
यस
आई वुड लाइक टू कंसीडर द पॉइंट एज एच ओव्हर हियर सो दिस अँगल विल बी अल्टीमेटली 90 डिग्री बरोबर आहे का हॉरिझॉन्टल लाइन आहे वर्टिकल लाइन आहे 90 डिग्री झाला मीन्स द एफ एच जी दिस लोड विल बी द युनिफॉर्मली
Varying
load. So this is a UVL, uniformly varying load. Whereas DFHB, it will be uniformly
distributed load.
Okay, and here on both the sides, it is a uniformly varying load. So now tell me, what is the intensity of the UDL and what is the intensity of a UVL for this combination? Intensity of a UDL and intensity of a UVL for this combination.
10 UDL.
10.
10. Kuthe paryanta 10 re?
H paryanta.
H paryanta. So I would like to mark at the point H intensity as a 10 kilonewtons per meter. Okay. So means from H to the B, it's a 10 kilonewtons per meter. And what about this remaining UVL uniformly varying load? So its intensity will be from
10.
It will be remaining one. So kiti asnar di?
10
kilonewtons per meter. It means that will be required to firstly convert this given varying load or combined varying load, we can say, in terms of UDL and UVL. Okay. So we will do that firstly, and then we'll go for the reactions and all those things. Okay. So firstly, we'll consider which one you want to go for, UDL or UVL out of this?
UDL.
UDL. So consider a UDL of 10 kilonewton per meter. Tell me now that you have to do this. Now, DFHB. Okay. So it's a point load firstly. Is equals to, what is the equation? काय फॉर्म्युला पॉइंट लोड कन्वर्ट करायचं इंटेन्सिटी इनटू द स्पॅन सो गो फॉर दॅट इंटेन्सिटी किती मत यूडीएल ची ह्या 10 आहे इनटू स्पॅन किती रे
3
मीटर्स दॅट इज इक्वल्स टू 30 किलो न्यूटन्स हा झाला यूडीएल चा पॉइंट लोड याचं पुढचं काय असणार आहे Point of application. कुठं असतो रे पॉइंट ऑफ ऍप्लिकेशन
थ्री बाय टू 1.5 मीटर
फ्रॉम विच सी या ए
फ्रॉम बी और डी
consider from D or B. Okay. This is for a UDL. Now, we'll go for the UVL. Now, consider a UVL of 10 kilonewton per meter. So, कोणता घेतोय बघा इथं 10 kilonewton per meter चा पुन्हा आणखी एक UVL आहे. आपण कोणता घेतोय?
FGH.
FGH. Okay. So, firstly, point load. Now, what is the equation for finding point load of UVL?
One half base into height.
That is 1/2 span into intensity. So what is the span? Base is how much?
Three meters.
Three into height.
Ten kilonewton per meter.
Is a 10. So what is the magnitude?
15 kilonewton.
15 kilonewton. Okay. Now it's a point of application. So go for it's a point of application. Side by side, go for a writing also. Point of application. Kutha asto re point of application acha?
One third of span.
Pan kuthun asto?
90 degree.
Exactly. From 90 degree. That is equals to 1/3 of a span means base. That is a 3 meters. That is equals to 1 meter. कुठून असणार आता हे
एच पासून
एच पासून
एच पासून फ्रॉम एच सो वी हैव कन्वर्टेड दिस UDL and UVL to the point loads and we have calculated their points of applications also. Okay. तर मी डिरेक्टली याच्यावरती दाखवत नाही नंतर दाखवतो त्यांना. आता पुढचं आपल्याला घ्यायचं आहे. कोणता असेल पुढचा तर आयदर CEA or EAD. Which one you want to go for firstly?
CEA.
DEA. So go for. So next one that is a UVL. Of intensity 10 kilo newton per meters. That is a हाँ कौन सा मतलब तुम्हें CEA. Okay. Now firstly a point load. Triangle है one half base into height inner. It is a base is nothing but the span and height is nothing but the intensity. That is equals to one half into base is a 1 meters and height is a 10 meter.
10 meters.
Is it 5 kilonewton?
Yes, sir.
Then point of application is equals to 1/3 of a span from 90 degree. That is equals to 1/3 into 1. Hey, kuthun asil rahe 1/3 into 1 from
point A.
From right angle triangle A.
A towards towards D or C?
C.
C.
Towards a C. That is equals to 0.334 meters. Is it correct?
Yes.
Now go for the remaining one. Now who else remain? This one is remain no? E D A.
E D A.
So go for uniformly a varying load of 10 kilonewtons per meter. Hey, ikadcha side se na. And it's a name as a EAD. So firstly, a point load. Once again, triangle is there. So one half base that is a span into height as a intensity. हाँ बोला काय काय लेता
1 half into 2 into 10
2 into 10
that is 10 kilonewton
that is a 10 kilonewtons
kilonewton
point of application
point of application
1/3 of span
1/3 of a span that is equals to 1/3 of किती 1 की 3 1/3 of kiti 1 at 3 at 2
2
that is a 2 so that is
0.667
0.667 meters from a to
d from a
to the d will be there okay so this is the conversion of the UDLs and UVLs to the point loads and their points of applications. Now the next is we have to show the directions of the reactions at A and at B. So at A how many reactions will be there?
2 only.
At A how many reactions will be there?
Only one
reaction because support is a roller support. Okay, so support the roller is a resting on this roller is a rolling on this surface. So reaction will be perpendicular to this surface. Surface is a horizontal, so reaction will be a vertical. So this is a reaction. Now tell me the probable direction of a reaction. RA, upward or downward?
Upward.
We will assume that it is going vertically upward. This is about A. Now, what about the B? Support is a hinge. So how many reactions will be there?
Two reactions.
So generate the x and y axis dottedly. So this will be RBY that is a vertical and this will be RBX that is a horizontal. Tell me direction of RBY upward or downward. Probable I want to have.
Downward.
Probable direction of RBY upward or downward we have to assume.
Upward.
We will assume that upward. Let it be. If answer is wrong then only it will be negative. What about the RBX? Right side, left side?
Right side.
Right side.
Left side.
Right side. Okay. So RBX we have shown, RBY we have shown. Now we'll go for the FBD because a number of forces and all those things are much more here in this case. So we'll go for the FBD now. Firstly, I would like to go for the beam as it is. Then given dimensions, and then we'll go for the dimensions of those we have found out. So firstly, I would like to mark here the line for marking the spans. Those are given to us. Here, there is only one reaction, that is a vertical. Here, there are two reactions. One is along the y-axis and another one is along the x-axis. Directions mean antar dakhavto tyancha. Okay. Then, now, tell me the side by side. This is A, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this end as A. Reaction was only one. Sorry. Beam was extending towards the left hand side also, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I'd like to consider the beam is extending towards the left hand side like this. Now we'll go for this end as A, only one reaction vertically upward, that is RA. What is the distance? This distance?
1 meter.
This is a 1 meter. Okay. Then the name which we have given here, this is a B. We have assumed RBX towards the right hand side, and we have assumed the RBY vertically upward. Okay. Then RBX we had shown, RBY we had shown. We have given the names also, na? A, B. Ito kuda dekh, now dil dabana, to dekha?
1 centimeter.
1 meter varti na, sorry. This is a 1 meter. Kuta parenta, yuta parenta 1 meter hota te. This is a 1 meter and remaining is a 3 meters.
Sir, 2 meter is here.
Yes, sir, 2 meter is sir. Kita.
This is a 2 meters. Okay, so this is a 2 meters. So read it as a 2 meters. Okay. Yala apan nav ka dil tari da?
D.
This name was a D. Okay. Now, tell me the forces. A cha left side leg hota. From A to left hand side. Barobar hai ka? The distance kiti hota?
1 meter.
Ikade
baka. Yacha A to the C wala. A to the C kuda hai? A to the C. Okay. Kiti hai? 0.334 meter hai. Kuda A person left side la. Ani force kiti hai? 5 kilonewton force.
5 kilonewton.
Okay, so I'd like to go for firstly that force of a magnitude 5 kilonewtons. Suppose that this is a force, it is a point load of intensity 5 kilonewton and span was 0.334 meters. So whatever the spans which we have calculated, je apan point load chi distance kadli astat, point of application, then nehmi beam cha varti dakhvat chala. तब पुढचा ए टू डी वाला किती होता रे 1.334 ना
मीटर 0.667
ओके सो वी विल अज्यूम दैट समवेयर एल्स हियर वी आर अज्यूमिंग दैट दिस डिस्टेंस इज अ 0.667 मीटर्स ओके आणि हा लोड किती होता पॉइंट लोड तो
10 किलो न्यूटन
सो दिस इज अ 10 किलो न्यूटन ओके तर या पोर्शन मध्ये डी टू बी मध्ये दोन फोर्सेस असतील बरोबर आहे का
यस सर
पहिला जो होता आपला तो कोणता होता इथला 10 × 3 30 वाला ना
1.5 मीटर
30 वाला 1.5 म्हणजे बरोबर सेंटरला असणार इथं
यस
आई वुड लाइक टू गो फॉर दिस फोर्स फर्स्टली which is at a distance of 1.5 meters.
1.5 meters.
From D. मी D पासून 1.5 घेतोय म्हणजे B पासून किती असेल रे?
1.5
मीटर. तर पुढचा एक शिल्लक राहिला तो कोणता आहे? UVL चा. बरोबर आहे का या UVL चा 15 किलो न्यूटन वाला?
1 आहे सर.
15 kilonewton distance 1 meter barobar hai na
yes sir
okay so go for that at a distance of 1 meter assume that I am assuming here as a 1 meter and the load as a 15 kilonewtons this is a 15 kilonewton and the span as a 1 meter from b mag d pasun kiti asel
2 kilometers 2
meters 5
meters from b are yacha magnitude lehaycha raila kiti utare ha
30
This is a 30 kilonewton, and this is nothing but the FBD of a given beam. And kya chhod ka dakhwa jaane lega apna? Is we had shown all the forces and reactions over it. अपन सर्व फोर्सेस रिएक्शन दाखिल
नाउ
नेक्स्ट वन वी हैव टू अप्लाई कंडीशंस ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम नाउ हियर वी हैव रिमेंड वन डिस्टेंस अपने डिस्टन्स दाखिल बो कु रे पॉइंट पास इतपर्यंत कि फोर्स पास पर्यत कि If this is a 0.667 meter, what could be the remaining distance here?
1.33
meters. So this distance is a 1.33. Now, next, applying conditions of equilibrium. Now the next line. Applying. Conditions of equilibrium. We get. So, which are those conditions? First is the summation moment.
Summation moment is equal to at point is equal to zero.
Summation
F is equal to zero. Huh. F is zero. Summation
F is zero. पहला कौन था गया जा?
Moment at point.
At point A or B.
A.
At which point we have to take the moment?
B.
Taking moment at point B. Therefore, summation moment at point B is equals to zero. So now tell me who will become zero?
RBY, RBX.
RBY and RBX will become zero. So start one by one, either from left hand side or from the right hand side. Kudun se start karte sanga.
Left hand side.
Left side se shuru karo ya. So first force is the 5 kilonewton.
5 kilonewton.
Pushing downward. So rotation at B, clockwise, anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise.
Down there then minus 5.
Minus 50.
0.334 This is a 0.334.
Sir, okay. 5.334.
So 3 plus 2 is a 5. 5 plus 0.33.
5.33.
5.334.
5.334 will be there. Okay. So we got the distance for a 5 kilonewton. Next one, R A pushing upward. So rotation at B, clockwise, anti-clockwise. Rotation clockwise, anti-clockwise due to R A.
Clockwise.
So this will be plus reaction R A into. What about its distance?
5.
Five. Five. 3 plus 2. Now next is a 10 kilonewton pushing downward. So rotation at B will be clockwise or anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise minus.
So minus 10 into distance
4.33
इकडे बघा ना b ते d किती आहे 3 मीटर आहे
4.33
सो डिस्टन्स विल बी 4.33 ओके सो 10 इज ओवर नाउ व्हिच इज रिमेन 30 विल गो फॉर 30 पुशिंग डाउनवर्ड सो रोटेशन इज अ
एंटी
क्लॉकवाइज सो माइनस 30 इंटू डिस्टन्स ऑफ 30 इज अ 1.5 नाउ व्हाट एल्स रिमेन
माइनस 15
15 is remained. So 15 pushing downward again. So rotating the B in a anti-clockwise sense. So that is the
minus 15.
Distance 1 is 1.5.
1
is equals to 0. Now do the summation of those constant terms firstly. This one, then this one, this and this one.
सर ते 5.334 कसं आलं सांग ना
किती आपला पहिला फोर्स 5 किलो न्यूटन आहे इथं ऍक्ट होतोय पॉइंट ऑफ ऍप्लिकेशन इथं झाला मोमेंट सेंटर इथं आहे ओके सो डिस्टन्स विल बी फ्रॉम बी टू धिस पॉइंट बी टू द ए किती आहे 3 मीटर्स प्लस 2 मीटर 5 मीटर आणि पुढे किती आहे 0.334 मीटर आहे सो डिस्टन्स विल बी 5.334 मीटर अंडरस्टूड
Yes, sir.
Okay, so go for next one now. Calculations. 5 into 5.334 and then minus 10 into 4.33 minus 30 into 1.5 minus 15 into 1. Is it minus 129.97?
Yes, sir. Minus 129.97.
Okay, so RA into 7 minus
129
sir, 5 and 5 RA into 5 minus 129.97 is equals to 0 that is RA is equals to ikade minus hai ikade gelo kay honar plus honar 129.97 upon 5 so RA
25.994
25.994 kilo newtons. This is the summation. Sorry, this is the sum for a RA by a moment equation. Understood for RA. Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. Now, the next one we have to calculate, that is a RBY. So, what we have to do?
Sorry. Summation FY is equal to 0.
So, go for that. So, firstly, I'd like to go for a straight line over here as a partition. Consider a summation of the forces along the y-axis is equals to 0. Okay. So, now, tell me the equation firstly. 5 plus or minus?
Minus 5.
RA plus or minus?
Plus RA.
10.
Minus 10.
Minus 15.
RBY is a plus. It has to be because of upward. Now put up the known values and find out the magnitude. So minus 5 plus 25.994 minus 55. Barobar ka? Is it correct? Whatever I have written over here. 20, 45, is it 65.994
5.995
हा तेच ना 24 point something.
Minus 24.006.
Right. So write down there. Minus 24.006 plus reaction RBY is equals to zero. That is RBY is equals to.
सर वेगळी ती वाटतं सर
कारण 30 आणि 15 45 आणि पुढचे 10 राहिले ना सर ते 10 45
10 45 सर एकूण ते
दॅट विल बी 65 या 55
इट्स अ
34.006 kiloton. Okay, so RBY is equals to 34.006. Now regarding the RBX, consider summation Apex is equals to zero. So it will be a zero. Ki RBX la konta force ahe X direction wala? There is no force along the X axis. Okay. So therefore RB will be equals to 34.006. Mi directly lihta. म्हणजे आपण आरबी कसा काढणार रूट ऑफ आरबी एक्स स्क्वेअर प्लस रूट ऑफ आरबी वाय स्क्वेअर आरबी एक्स इज अ झिरो सो ओनली आरबी वाय विल बी देअर हुज मॅग्निट्यूड इज 34.006 किलो न्यूटन आणि अल्फा किती असेल रे अल्फा किती असेल झिरो की 90 अल्फा झिरो की
90
डिग्रीज म्हणजे व्हर्टिकल असणार आहे अलॉंग द आरबी वाय resultant reaction RB will be there. मी दाखवून देतो त्याला. So here along the same line of action the RB will be there. It's not necessary to show over here but I had shown. झाले का सर्वांचं? बाबांनो झाले? तरीही याच्यामधला माझा एक टाईप राहिला सर एक घेऊया आपण 10 मिनिटं आणखी आपल्याकडे हे सर्वांना झाले का लगेच घेऊ तो पुढचं एक्झाम्पल मी म्हणजे लगेच संपून जाईल ते कॅन्टिलिव्हर बीम आपण घेतलंच नाही ना कॅन्टिलिव्हर घेतलं नाहीये डबल बीम घेतली नाहीये अरे रे 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 आपण खूपच टाइमपास केलेला हे झालं का सर्वांचं कॅन आय गो फॉर नेक्स्ट वन
येस सर
Yes, sir.
Okay, chalo. We'll go for the next example. Firstly, I would love to separate it. The next one is the it was asked in May 3, 12 marks, 2.5.6. Mi ata change karto tyachyamadhye thoda sa. Example number 2.5.6, but I want to change something in it. Cantilever beam ahe. Mala ita दोन एक्झाम्पलचं कॉम्बिनेशन करायचंय सो आय लाईक टू गो फॉर दॅट हा कॅन्टिलिव्हर बीम आहे आणि इट इज एम्बेडेड इन अ वॉल दिस इज अ वॉल अँड इनसाइड इट इट हॅज बीन एम्बेडेड एंड्स विल कन्सिडर अरे कुठला कलर लिहिल रे याच्यावरती डार्क होते आता लाल दिसते का दिसते दिसते ए अँड बी ऍट एंड बी नाव इन्स्टेड ऑफ द पर्टिक्युलर लोड आय हॅव टू गो फॉर अ इन्क्लाइंड लोड आपण इन्क्लाइंड लोडच घेतलंच नाही ना एक्झाम्पल सपोज दॅट दिस हॅज अ 10 किलो न्यूटन्स अँगल विल कन्सिडर ऍज अ 30 डिग्री टू द हॉरिझॉन्टल एकच घेऊ फोर्स म्हणजे जरा पटकीनं संपून जाईल आपला स्पॅन विल कन्सिडर ऍज अ 4 मीटर्स ऍट ए इट इज अ फिक्स्ड अँड ऍट बी इट इज अ फ्रीली हँगिंग साईड बाय साईड सर्वांनी अटेंडन्स द्या ओके सो विल कन्सिडर द बीम ए बी लाईक दिस आय हॅव मेड द एक्झाम्पल ऍज सिम्पल ऍज बिकॉज आय वॉन्टेड टू have an understanding of the concept over here because we had not considered the inclined force in examples which we have seen in the previous classes. Okay, so what I did, now I had considered the cantilever beam whose one of the end is fixed or embedded here in a wall, we will consider, and its another end is a free, and at the free end there is a force of 10 kilonewton which is inclined at angle of 30 degree to the horizontal, and it is asked to find out the reactions those will be get developed at point A. Now at A there is a hinge, fixed support, so how many reactions will be there at A? How many reactions will be there at A as fixed support is there?
Three
reactions for displacement, that is along x and y, and for rotation. So firstly we'll see for a rotation. As per as the point A is considered, in which direction the body will or the beam will rotate at the point A? Clockwise and anticlockwise. Rotation kaso will be possible?
Clockwise, sir.
Clockwise will. Manje moment reaction je asnar ti kashi asel re? Moment reaction clockwise ki anticlockwise?
Clockwise.
Moment reaction I am talking about. Moment manat nahi hai. Force
clockwise.
Force mule honara rotation clockwise hai parantu hote ka nahi hai, means the moment reaction mr, we can say that moment reaction at A will be in a anticlockwise direction. So mra, that is the moment reaction at A will be in anticlockwise direction. Now what about the direction about along the y axis, vertically upward or vertically downward? Ray upward or downward? Action downward hote ki upward hote force bagha bar? Let it be wrong. Wrong ala tari chalel ka harkat nahi hai.
Downward, sir.
Downward, we'll consider it is a downward. Let it be correct or wrong. Then rax, right hand side, left hand side, rax kut ge sanga, left lage che ki right lage che? Let it be. Bula, huh?
Right.
We'll consider right. Towards the right hand side. Let it be correct or wrong. Okay. Now, apply the conditions of equilibrium. Write down here. Applying conditions of equilibrium, we get. Applying conditions of equilibrium. So that is summation moment is equals to zero. Summation of forces along the y-axis is equals to zero, and summation of forces along the x-axis is equals to zero. Now, which equation we have to go for firstly?
Moment.
At which point? A or B?
A.
At A is equals to zero. Now tell me who will become zero if we'll take moment at A?
Rax.
Ray. Rax and Ray will become zero. What about the moment reaction? MRA, will it become zero? It will not.
No, current delay moment.
No, no, apnar kadaychi.
Okay,
but it will not become zero. Okay, so write down equation. So MRA, it is a anticlockwise. So it is a minus moment reaction at A. Then now the force is inclined, so will be required to resolve it, extend its line of action. So along the x-axis, its component will be x component, that is fx, and vertically downward will be the fy. So what about the moment of the fx?
Zero.
It will be zero. So what else remain?
Fy.
Clockwise, anticlockwise rotation at A.
Clockwise.
So it will be plus fy into its perpendicular distance as a 4 is equals to 0. That is minus moment reaction at A plus fy means f sine theta. That is a 10 sine 30 into 4 is equals to 0. That is minus moment reaction at A plus sine 30 is half. Half of 10 is a 5. 5 into 4 as a 20 equals to 0. That is moment reaction MRA is equals to
minus 20,
but both the sides are having minus sign, so it will be ultimately plus. So moment reaction at A is a 20 newton meter. I have not multiplied this moment reaction by distance because it is already a moment. okay? So it is not required to go for multiplying the same. Now we got the moment reaction. Now next is we have to find out the reaction along the y-axis and the reaction along the x-axis. So consider a summation Fy is equals to zero. What about the Ray, plus or minus?
Minus.
So minus Ray. What about the Fy, plus or minus?
Minus.
Minus Ray is equals to zero. Sorry, हाँ बरोबर है हाँ. Ray दोनों वाले लम्बी या Fy लिखा जो देता. This will be Fy. So that is a minus Ray is equals to plus Fy. That is Ray is equals to minus force is a 10 sine of 30. That is a minus 5 kilo newton. ये तो unit kilo newton ना सिल्की रे अपलो. बरोबर ना? This will be kilonewton meter. So Ray is a negative. It means that direction, assumed direction is a wrong. So Ray is equals to plus 5 kilonewton. Direction will be upward or downward now. Correct direction.
Upward.
Upward.
Upward. Upward. So assume the direction is a upward. So make it is a by a larger arrow, larger dimension arrow and tick it on. As a upward, okay. So Ray is known to us now. Now next is a Rax. Take the summation Fx equals to zero. So Rax towards the right hand side. That is a plus Rx. So Fx is also towards the right hand side. Plus Fx is equals to zero. That is Rax is equals to minus Fx. That is Rax is equals to minus 10 cos 30. 30 is na? That is Rax is equals to minus 8.67. Is it correct? Minus 8.67.
Nahi sir, 8.66 hai na. Pura zero hai.
8.6 hai ka? Check the answer.
Sir, 8.66.
That is reaction Rax is equals to plus 8.66 kilonewton. Correct direction. Kuta asel ata? Right la left. Left la asnar. Karan right la apan assume kelta te aplo wrong alelo hoto. So this is towards the left hand side. So left hand side arrow we have to make up a larger dimension and make a tick on it. Then find out the Ra is equals to root of Rax square plus Ray square. That is equals to, tell me directly magnitude for Ra. In kilonewtons. Similarly, find out the alpha is equals to tan inverse of Ray divided by Rax. That is alpha is equals to Rax is a 8.667 square plus 5, it's a square root of answer, it's a 10. Is Ra is a 10?
Yes sir.
10 kilonewton. Then alpha tan inverse of kona kona cha tan inverse to Ray, that is a 5 divided by Rax is a 8.66. Is it 30 degree?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then show the direction. Ek kuda chal raha hai Ra? Upward or downward? Check kar raha. Main x and y axis kaad dusra batla itho. X axis, y axis. Summation Fx towards the left hand side. Barobar? Summation Fy vertically upward. So the resultant will be in which quadrant? Which quadrant resultant?
Second quadrant.
Second quadrant. So this will be our RA with an angle alpha. So this is a reaction RA and its angle alpha also we have calculated. Okay, this is the alpha. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you for your kind attention and we will stop over here and then we'll start for the next lecture in the next class, that is for the new unit, next unit, that is unit number 3, analysis of pin jointed plane trusses. Okay, thank you.